Hi everyone, it's Vignesh from Code Android. Today we are going to see how to set up start activity for result. Activities can do some tasks and it can return the value to the class which started this activity. To capture the result of those activities, we need to use start activity for result while launching. In this example, we are going to read the file from internal or external memory. We will launch an implicit indent which will return the selected file path. Using this, we can access the file in our activity. To demonstrate this, I am creating an application with default configuration. Open activity_main.xml. Change the root layout to linear layout and adding orientation as vertical. Converting the text view to button and setting text as open file. Also assigning ID as btn_read. Adding a text view to show the content of the file and assigning ID as tv_read_data. Setting onclick listener for btn_read. Inside creating an intent with action get content as parameter, setting type as */txt, starting the intent using start activity for result. An activity can contain one or more start activity for result. In that case, we don't know which one is returning the result. So we need to pass an integer while starting the activity. Because when the activity returns the result, the same integer will be returned. Using that, we can handle the result accordingly. Creating a constant value file picker ID and assigning an integer. Now, we can start an activity and wait for its result. But where we will get the result? To get the result, we need to override a method called onActivityResult. I am checking request code is matching with the code which we sent. Also checking response code result OK or not. If both are true, then creating a file from the data which we received. We can create a file like this. But this might crash sometime because if you select a file from downloads, Android will return path like document:// Using that, we can't create file object directly. I found a pathutil file which will convert those path into actual file path. So, adding the pathutil file in this project and passing context and URI to pathutil. Getting the file content using file input stream, also reading the file using buffered reader. Now setting the resulted data as a text for tv_read_data. Let's launch the application. Note that I am selecting an emulator running on Lollipop. If you select Marshmallow or later emulators, the application will crash due to permission denial. We'll handle that in next tutorial. Sorry, type */txt is not working, so I am changing it to */*. It will show all the file types. Also, I forgot to add read external storage permission on AndroidManifest.xml, so adding that. Let's launch the application. I already copied a text file into emulator by dragging the file into emulator so that the file will be copied into downloads folder. Selecting the text file, click on OK. You can see the file content is displayed on text view. That's all for this tutorial guys. If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. If you have any doubt, please put it in the comment section. I will try to answer it. Hope you like it. I will see you on my next video. Have a good day.